What up, YouTube? Spike Robot here with another video, and you know what? I have to say, the Sonic the Hedgehog fanbase has some of the worst displays of fanboyism I've ever seen. I grew up with Sonic the Hedgehog, so I can safely say that it is no joke. Other fanbases may have annoying fanboyism, but none are on the level of the Sonic fanbase. Now, I'm not talking about the recolorists or the furries. I don't really give a shit what they do. I will say, though, recolorists feel like they have to claim they're making artistic creations that they made on their own. You don't have to. There's nothing wrong with changing the colors of the Sonic characters. Just do it for fun. In fact, I can see the appeal in that, and Sonic Team sort of did them themselves in Shadow the Hedgehog's two-player mode, where they created a Shadow Android with yellow stripes instead of red. And if people think you're weird for doing it, then they need to change. Also, people who complain about furries really need to know this. The furries are not attracted to the animal parts of the anthropomorphic animals. They are attracted to the human characteristics of the characters. Okay? Just because someone is attracted to Rouge the Bat, Amy Rose, or Blaze the Cat, or whoever the fuck, does not mean they want to fuck bats or hedgehogs or cats. I mean, I am not a furry, and nor am I sexually attracted to any of the Sonic characters, but I still know this. Although Rouge would be pretty explosive in bed. But let's get to the moment you've all been waiting for. Who am I talking about? I'm talking about the elitists and or the hardcore old school Sonic fans. These are people like a Knothole Resident, Mario Da Plumber, Sonic and Tails for Life, or hell, even someone like Game Dude. So, get prepared for another retrospective rant. I mean, where do I even begin with these idiots? These fans seem to think that they're better Sonic fans than anyone else because they enjoy the classic Sonic games. They also bitch and complain about stupid shit that most people would not even notice, and therefore wouldn't care about. Even worse, they act like it's really fucking important, and we're the idiots for letting it slide. Oh, the level of pretentiousness is through the goddamn roof. As for liking classic Sonic games over the newer ones, I understand that is their opinion, and hell, I tend to prefer some of the older games. But that doesn't mean I don't try to see the good in the newer games. At all. I don't just bash everything about the newer games. However, these guys say these things as if they're facts. And they have flat out insulted people who enjoy the modern Sonic games. It's called personal preference. If you say a classic Sonic games are better, you're actually saying, I enjoy classic Sonic games more than modern Sonic games. It would be so much fucking better if you would just say that. But no, they just have to fucking flesh out their superiority complex when talking about the Sonic games. Like, when Sonic and Tails for Life heard that a person he was commentating on, Shadow Star, said he preferred modern Sonic games. And Sonic and Tails for Life asked him if he was high. Do I even need to explain how how insulting that fucking question is? Sonic and Tails for Life... Oh, Sonic and Tails for Life's words are poison to my ears. They also say that Sonic games should only have... They also say that Sonic games should only have Sonic, Tails, and Dr. Robotnik. Why? Honestly, some of the other Sonic game characters have great, if not decent, personalities. Shadow the Hedgehog is honestly one of my favorite characters in the whole series. No one established that goddamn rule except you guys, and you have no credibility. You think you do, but you don't. Mario the Plumber called Shadow the Hedgehog an emo and said that Knuckles looked and talked like an N-word. Which was fucking retarded. Both of these insults were goddamn pathetic and stupid. And God, Mario the Plumber's voice is so fucking annoying! It is literal ear rape. Not to mention he is racist and homophobic. And that is three problems of the many problem. And that's three of the many problems with his lame Sonic Adventure 2 review. I don't even need to play the game to know that his review is goddamn awful. I mean, he hardly went into any detail. But these ultra hardcore retro Sonic fans have also complained about this. A Knothole resident is most infamous for this. They complained that Sonic's eye color was changed from black to green, which is the most fucking retarded thing to bitch and moan over. You have way too much fucking time on your hands to complain about that. I noticed that when I was a kid. And as autistic as I was, I honestly didn't care. I thought it was odd, but I did not go into an OCD fit over it like an awful resident, and frankly, a lot of other idiotic old school Sonic fans did. He even said that the level design and the graphics in Sonic the Hedgehog 4 were aesthetically pleasing, but the feeling of nostalgia was lost because they used the green-eyed Sonic model. You're pathetic. And I don't want to hear any more of, and stop calling it the green-eyed stretched-out hentai Sonic. That is fucking stupid. They also have a habit of insulting the Sonic X voice actors, even when they were not voicing the characters anymore. God damn it, stop bringing them up in a conversation, because all you do is say that they all suck, which is completely unfair. Okay, what do I think of the Sonic X voice actors? Well, they're a mixed bag. There are some good voices, like Espio, Dr. Eggman, and Shadow, who is also voiced by Jason Griffith. I actually think he does a better Shadow voice than Sonic voice. There are some that are okay, like Rouge, Tails, Sonic, and Amy. But there are some really bad ones, like Cream, Charmy, and Vector. And what does it matter anyway? They're not voicing the characters anymore. All I hear from these guys is, Sonic games all suck now. Sonic is now green eye, but his eyes should be black. The four kids' voice actors suck. Seriously, all they do is bitch and moan. And all in a very arbitrary way. And some of the critics of Sonic games kind of tap into that mindset a little bit, even if it's not as extreme as these fanboys. It is very worrying to me how influential these people are. And you might be asking, well, if you hate the Sonic fan base so much, why don't you just leave it? Well, there are two very important reasons why I stay in the Sonic fan base. The first is, I really enjoy playing the Sonic games. Not necessarily all of them, but the best ones have excellent gameplay and level design. It is a series that gives me a sense of nostalgia. I mean, there were times where I almost gave up on it, but I just can't give up on it. I enjoyed the games that much. I really do. The second reason is that despite what I said, there are some Sonic fans who are not like these old school Sonic fanboys. People like Shatsilson11, aka Tom Hedgehog, who enjoy some of the newer Sonic games, in addition to the classics, are people who are very intelligent and make decent arguments, and don't get all self-righteous on those who disagree with them. More people need to learn from these people. Tom Hedgehog has even called out Sonic and Tails for Life and Mario the Fucker, and especially Game Dude, saying that more or less what I've been saying, like that they think they are more intelligent than the people who enjoy the newer games. But the ultimate irony is that the people who enjoy the newer Sonic games more than likely come off as more intelligent and a hell of a lot nicer and cooler than the old school Sonic fanboys. And if you don't believe me, this is really prevalent, or was. But I can back my shit up. I will be giving links in the description of examples of this. Okay. As a fan of Sonic the Hedgehog, I cannot stand these fucking guys, but it is what it is. So, anyway, I hope you all enjoyed this video. I'm Spike Robot. Thank you all for watching. If you like this video, you can subscribe to my channel, and see you later. Support our troops.
On the street.